Everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel Fictional Brawl, and in this video I will be discussing how powerful is the My Hero Academia verse in general. Now many people downplay My Hero Academia god tiers and even the entire verse at around large town level only and in speed at only massively hypersonic, which is simply not true. And in this video I will be showing you how powerful and how fast is the My Hero Academia verse is in general. So even in the UA entrance examination arc, we have seen many characters do building level to large building levels of feats, which would already put even the weakest My Hero Academia characters at around large building levels of attack potency, which is consistent since even the characters who don't have the quirks that can destroy or damage such large buildings or other things, they have shown that they have the durability to survive these types of attacks. Now the most impressive feat that comes in the season 1 is from the USJ Nomu arc, in which Deku creates a water storm with his Delaware smash, which was carried out to be around 102 tons of TNT, which is multi-city block level. So this proves that even the weaker My Hero Academia characters are from large building level to city block levels in terms of power and speed. And as for season 2, we have seen that in Shoto Todoroki during the sports festival arc create a massive iceberg which was carried out to be around 11 megatons of TNT, which is small city level, and this is also equivalent to the nuclear bomb, the strongest nuclear bomb ever tested, which was carried out to be around 15 megatons of TNT, and its yield is clearly superior to the Hiroshima bomb that was fired by America. And here is in the first two heroes feat of Bakugo, where he destroys multiple cubes fired by Wolfram, which were carried out to be around 500 kilotons of TNT or large town level. So this shows you that even other weaker characters in the My Hero verse are around large building level to town level, and the sum of the strongest ones at around 11 megatons of TNT, which is small city level. So in bare minimum, this debunks the down players that think that My Hero verse is only at small building level or small town level is simply false. Even Deku and Bakugo without any type of prep or without even being aware and completely off guard were able to survive All Might's attack, which was scaled out to be around 6.38 kilotons of TNT, which is again a town level feat. So this already proves that My Hero Academia characters at this point, such not only Deku and Bakugo but other characters such as Kirishima, Uraraka, Dark Shadow, Yaorozu are already in the town levels of ranges. Even though they don't scale higher than this, but they should still be at comfortably town levels of power. Next up is we have got in the Heroes Rising movie, when it is again evidence that characters like Ayoma and Mina Ashido were able to create another town level feat which was carried out to be around town levels of power. So this should again prove that other class 1A members are at around town levels of destructive capacity. Now as for some higher stuff, we know that a weakened All Might with Deku's help was able to destroy Wolfram's metal cube, which is about to destroy the entire Eye Island, and the feat energy calculated out for this feat is around 426 gigatons of TNT. Now the USJ Nomu was able to fight on par with this weakened version of All Might, and according to Dr. Garaki's statement, a higher Nomu is comparable to the same USJ Nomu that fought a weakened All Might. And Mirko in the manga has been able to kill 6 high-end Nomus. So this would put Mirko's durability and attack potency at around 2.6 teratons of TNT, since she has been able to kill 6 high-end Nomus, and all of them are as strong as a large island level All Might. So the characters that scale from Mirko's attack potency would be Endeavor, best genius and mount lady and other pro heroes. So they all should be at around large island level to small country level in terms of power. Now, if we go on to the most impressive My Hero Academia feat, this happens in the movie Heroes Rising, where Deku and Bakugo disperses 9th stop. The feat was itself carried out to be at around large country level, equal to 286 teratons of TNT. So if we were to take that Deku which dispersed the 9th storm along with Bakugo as All Might's base form, then, and if we plug on the 60 times multiplier for All Might as stated by him himself, that when he fought the USJ Nomu, he gave 300 punches and that in his prime he would only require 5 punches to defeat Nomu. So by this we can assume that All Might in his prime is 60 times stronger, and if we take a base All Might to be equivalent to Heroes Rising Deku, since Deku at that time was already able to use 21% of One For All, then this should put prime All Might at around 20 petatons of TNT attack power and durability, which is high into multi-continental level ranges. And the characters who scale off of this are All For One Shigaraki and Prime All For One. Now, with this out of the way, I think I have already cleared that how My Hero Academia characters range, that even the weakest character is anywhere from large building level to city block level to even town levels and small city level in terms of power. And the strongest characters are from large island level to large country to even multi-continental in terms of destructive capacity and durability. Now, as for speed, My Hero Academia characters are pretty fast, and as shown that in season 2 during the sports festival arc, many characters were able to react and even dodge Bakugo's nitroglycerin bombs, which were carried out to be moving at around 8% the speed of light. This isn't an outlier, as it is supported that those characters were able to tank Denki Kaminari's lightning, which is also relativistic, and since Denki Kaminari in the movie Heroes Rising was able to tank 9's lightning, so this should already put even the weakened My Hero Academia characters or anybody below All Might and All For One should be at least relativistic in terms of speed. Now in the same movie, Deku has been able to dodge 9's lasers, so he should be at the FTL level, FTL ranges. One of his most impressive speed feats in the manga are when he dodges All For One Shigaraki's radio waves and the air cannon blast. Radio waves are stated that they specifically move at the speed of light, and Shigaraki also used an air cannon with that. And an air cannon, according to All For One statement, increases any attack's power by 3 to 4 times. Which means that 30% Deku that dodged Shigaraki's air cannon radio waves should be at anywhere from 3 to 4 times faster than the speed of light. And if we were to take this as for All Might's base, then Prime All Might would be at around 180 to 240 times the speed of light, and this isn't ranked, this is supported by MHL lore and the scaling supports it. So I hope that in this video I have debunked the MHA downplay and given you the proof that how powerful is the entire MHA verse in general. If you like my video, please give a like and subscribe. And on the future, I am hoping to do a Dragon Ball Super power scaling video and then a Yukiora Cypher power scaling video from Bleach. So, alright, meet you again in next video.